Getting families on the ice all season long and into the playoffs. Luther Kia of Bloomington. Come see the 7-passenger Telluride and all the new 2023 models at Luther Kia of Bloomington.
It's time for Breakaway, presented by Luther Kia of Bloomington with Wes Walls. I'm Audra Martin. Yes, it was a 60-minute hockey game, but it all came down to the final 40 seconds as the Wild answered back a late tying goal from the Nashville Predators, then get one for Wild 26 seconds later. A big 2 points that they pick up against a Central Division foe.
Yeah, you got to give the Nashville Predators a lot of credit because they were able to just hang in. I don't know how they did it because the Wild were the better team here tonight and definitely deserve the 2 points. I thought Audra in the first period, they could have been up 4 or 5-0. Soros was unbelievable. But at the end of the game, with the game on the line, Jared Spurgeon with a great little play across to his buddy Jonas Brodin, and the puck caroms off of McDonough and then off of Ryan Hartman. And the Wild are the team that picks up a huge 2 points in regulation that's going to be a heartbreaker for the Nashville Predators and the tough one to overcome. 7 points now behind the Minnesota Wild with a big goal there by Ryan Hartman.
Absolutely. So the season series is knotted up at one win apiece. This is the first regulation win for the Wild since January 17th. Special teams, it stays hot for Minnesota as well. Perfect 20 for 20 in a 7-game perfect streak, and with another power play goal here today, the Wild have goals in 11 of the last 13 games. Overall, a huge win, even though the Wild will admit they got a couple fortunate breaks.
A break, right? Or 2 breaks, right? So Duhaime's goal hits him. Last goal hits Hartsey. I mean, obviously, Kirill's. But, yeah, we caught a couple of breaks. We've talked about that for a while now, and we haven't got them our way. We had them go our way tonight, and it helped us with 2 points.
The 7-game homestand comes to an end on Tuesday as Kevin Fiala and the LA Kings come to town. They're 7-2-1 in their last 10, second in the Pacific Division. Better way to end the homestand than with another 2 points in hand. We hope to see you then. Thanks for joining us this afternoon on another edition of Breakaway, presented by Luther Kia of Bloomington.